Students will take one more numerical. I'll write the question for you, then we'll discuss. Okay. Let me draw the diagram first. There is a 4 kg block. So I'm not writing that, but I'm just explaining the question. There is a 4 kg block. The coefficient of friction between the block and the surface is 0.4. The force is applied towards right. Three different forces are applied. That I will write here. Three forces are applied here. This F1 equals to 15 Newton, F2 equals to 16 Newton, F3 equals to 20 Newton. So these are the three forces applied on this block separately. Now you have to find the acceleration produced in each of these cases. So find acceleration in each of these cases. Okay, let us find the acceleration that is produced because of these forces. So A, B, C, these three forces are separately applied, and we have to find the acceleration in all these cases. So if I say that F is the applied force, which is 15 Newton, I'll draw a picture here. Let us see, this is the force that is applied, this is 15 Newton, this is the applied force, F1. Now, how much, what is the capacity of this system to prevent? That is the limiting friction that we find as here, FL is mu s into N. Mu s is 0.4 as in the question here. N is, if this is the 4 kg block, then mg is the weight, which is 4 into g is 10, so 40 Newton. And therefore, the normal reaction is N, I'll write here. This normal reaction is equal to 40 because this block is not moving up and down, so therefore these two forces will balance each other. Therefore here normal reaction is 40 Newton. This is your normal reaction. Okay, and therefore this N will be this into 40, so this comes out to be 16 Newton. So the maximum friction that is produced here is 16 Newton, but then the friction that actually is applied on the object depends on the external force. Because the external force is 15, so therefore here the friction that will act equals to Fs equals to 15 Newton. Okay. Now, if this is the case, then what is the acceleration? You have to find acceleration in each of these cases. So then acceleration for this case will be, what will the acceleration for this case? Acceleration of the block is force, net force divided by mass. Net force is, you can see the free body diagram, 15 Newton towards right and 15 Newton towards left. So therefore 15 minus 15 divided by 4 kg mass. So this is 0 meter per second square is the answer. That means the body is not moving. Okay, the friction prevents its motion. Now, as far as this second part is concerned, you can see here that acceleration in the second case, if the force applied is 16 Newton, then what will be the free body diagram? If this is the block, this is the second case, B case, this is case A, I'm applying a force of 16, the frictional force will also be 16 because the maximum value of friction is 16. It can apply a maximum of 16, so it will definitely apply because its aim is to keep these two bodies together. So in this case also, 16 minus 16 divided by 4, it comes out to be 0 meter per second square. Now come to the third part of this. Let us see how much is the friction acceleration over here in the case of third one, acceleration is equal to net force divided by m. When the force applied is 20 newton, let us draw one more diagram over here. This is for C, and the applied force is 20 newton, and the frictional force will be definitely the maximum, because the applied force has exceeded the maximum value of limiting friction. So friction will give its best of 16, and the applied force is 20. So in this case, there will be net force. This diagram is equivalent to the body is applied a force of 4 newton towards right, because it's 20 minus 16. So 20 minus 16 divided by 4, 4 divided by 4, 1 meter per second square. So this is the answer to this question. That in the case of third, when the force is 20 newton, then only the body will start moving, and its value is this acceleration is 1 meter per second square. Okay. Thank you.